Assalamualaikum dear students, how are you? Once again I am with you with the same class, with the same chapter. So today our chapter is the same as I uploaded the one video, and I told you that I will also upload another video. I will continue the five personalities, the five women. Okay, so the role of women in Pakistan's creation, the name of chapter is same. So I will let you know about the five female personalities who supported, okay, to the Pakistan. Okay, so now I will start from the Mohtarma Fatma Jinnah. Actually, the Mohtarma Fatma Jinnah, she was born in 1893 and she died in 1969. And she was presented by Sana. Second is Begum Rana Liaqat Ali Khan. She was born in 1905 and died in 1990. She was presented by Samir. Third is Begum Jahan Ara Shah Nawaz. She was born in 1896 and she died in 1979, and she was presented by Razia. And now our fourth is Professor Anita Ghulam Ali. Actually, the Professor Anita Ghulam Ali, she was born in 1934 and died in 2014. And she was presented by Ahmad. Now our last and fifth is Bilqis Bano Eidi. She was born in 1947. She is still alive. And she was presented by Alia. Now I will read them out by the text, and I hope you will understand very well. I will use the easy words, okay, to make your mind clear. So now I will start from the Mohtarma Fatma Jinnah. She was born in 1893 and died in 1969. Actually, she was Qaidiya Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah's younger sister. She was the younger sister of Qaidiya Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. She helped him in the struggle for the establishment of Pakistan. It means she helped the Qaidiya Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah in the creation of Pakistan. She left Den Tistri to live with her brother and support him. It means she left her field of dentist and started to support his brother, okay, in the establishment of Pakistan. It means in the flourishing or in the creation of Pakistan. Her support continued for 28 years. It means she supported the Qaidiya Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah 28 years, including the last 19 tiring years, okay, of his life. It means in the last years of his life, it means he was very tired, even though she supported him. Now the Muslim women of the subcontinent, the women Muslim of the subcontinent were able to interview Muhammad Ali Jinnah and seek his guidance. It means the women of the subcontinents went and met with Qaidiya Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah, and they were in the leading of Qaidiya Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah, or they were leaded by the Qaidiya Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. After that is the Grateful Nation gave her the title of Madre Millat. It means the Fatma Jinnah was given a title that was Madre Millat, which means, and it was meant Mother of the Nation. It was her title. Okay, so this is the presentation of Sana. Okay, now I am coming to the next. Next is Begum Rana Liaqat Ali. She was born in 1905 and died in 1990. Okay, she worked as an honorary secretary and typist to her husband. It means that she was secretary and become typist of her husband. Which was, what was the name of her husband? The name of her husband was Liaquat Ali Khan. She became the secretary and the typist of Liaquat Ali Khan. Because at that time the Muslim League could not afford the salary of secretary. It means at the time when the Muslim League could not afford the salary of secretary, at that time her wife became the secretary and as well as the typist of her husband. She arranged meetings of the Muslim League. It means she also organized the meeting of Muslim League women with the wife and the daughter of the viceroy, so that they could explain to the issues and problems related to the Muslim women. It means she also organized so meetings, because the women means the wife and daughters, as they may discuss the problem which they were facing. Now is the she also organized the Muslim voluntary service and later the women's national guards. Okay, now she also organized a Muslim voluntary service and later she women's national guards, consisting of 3 battalions, with 2,400 girls, in which she herself had the rank of brigadier. It means she also made a field, or we can say the women's national guards, in which she was a battalions. It means she was a leader, and there were also the other girls. It means 24 girls, and it was a field through which they were fighting with the problems and issues. She herself held the rank of a brigadier. It means she became the brigadier of this, we can say, this organization. Okay. And she also the founder of All Pakistan Women Association. She is also the founder of what? Of the All Pakistan Women Association. And this is the presentation of Samir. Okay, now the third is Begum Jahan Ara Shahnawaz. She was born in 1896 and she died in 1979. She represented the Muslim women at the 3-table conference held in London. Okay, so 3 round table conference which were held in London, she represented the women. Okay, at that time she was the first woman to make a speech in London. Guild Hall. Okay, there was a Guild Hall in London. There she was the first to speak in the favor of women. She also traveled widely and explained to the people of other countries why the Muslims in India wanted a separate homeland. It means she also traveled in the different countries and she made them aware of that why the Muslims of the subcontinent, they want to get their separate homeland for them. So this is the presentation of Razia. Now the fourth is that Professor Anita Ghulam Ali. She was born in 1934 and died in 2014. Actually, she was a popular newscaster of the English news. She was newscaster of the English news and well-known teacher of her time. It means she was a newscaster and she was also a famous teacher. Okay, she also wrote several articles and books. She was also a writer. She wrote the many articles and books. She served twice as the Sindh Minister of Education. She had remained Minister of Education 3 times. In addition to being the Minister of Culture, Sciences, Technology, when she became the Minister of Culture, Science and Technology and Youth and Sport. It means she was the Minister of Science, Technology and Youth and the Sport. Professor Anita Ghulam was also the founding manager of the Sindh Education Foundation. Okay, she is a woman who kept foundation, are the basis for the what? Sindh Education Foundation. Government of Sindh. Under her leadership, the foundation played a remarkable role. It means when she kept the foundation of this education, it got we can say the popularity and become a successful one. Remarkable role in promoting quality education. It means she promoted the quality of education and bringing many out of school children to the school, particularly in the rural area of Sindh. It means the many children which were in the rural area, she brought them in the education, and she brought those children into the school which were out of the school. It means which may not get the education properly, she also provide them the good education and make them a system of the education. So the government of Pakistan recognizes her tremendous contribution to the cause of education. It means she was praised by, because she worked for the education, she was awarded the Pride of Performance and Sitare Imtiaz. She was also given the Sitare Imtiaz, contribution of education. It means she, because of her education, she was given as Sitare Imtiaz, which is the title of Pakistan, mostly given to the famous personalities. So this presentation was this presentation is by Emma. Actually, we have a short time, that's why I am telling you it fast. So this is our last woman. So Bilqis Banu Eidi. So Bilqis Banu Eidi was born in 1947. She was born in 1947, and still she is alive. Actually, she is philanthropist. The philanthropist is the person who support to the poor people, who support the humanity, who love the humanity. It means that she has been loving to the poor people and to the human beings, who is also trained as a professional nurse. And she is also a professional nurse. She is the widow of Abdul Sattar Eidi. She was the wife of Abdul Sattar Eidi. You know better the name of Abdul Sattar Eidi, and he is known worldwide. Who was renowned social worker? The Abdul Sattar Eidi was a renowned social worker, and her wife is also now is the head of same organization. She now heads the Eidi Foundation, which provides nationwide support. Actually, she is right now the head of Eidi Foundation, which provides worldwide support. Means which is supported by all the countries. Now my last paragraph, and care to the public. It means she also cares or takes care to the of the public, such as shelter, homes, and ambulance service. She this foundation of Sattar Abdul Eidi and the Banu Eidi, Bilqis Banu Eidi, they provide to the people what? Shelter, homes, and ambulance services. She has received Hilal Imtiaz. She has also received Hilal Imtiaz from the government of Pakistan in recognition of her tireless effort, because she has supported Pakistan alone. That's why she has also awarded what? Hilal Imtiaz. For the betterment of the society, she has also been named as the mother of Pakistan. She is also called the mother of Pakistan in this presentation.